Okay, so now we are going to navigate through some potentials of gene editing in transforming the healthcare research and innovation, and we'll have a brief journey in the gene editing and its different available techniques and its application, different real-life therapeutic applications, drug discovery application also in precision medicine, the impact on healthcare, which is well covered by my colleagues, ethical and regulatory considerations, technical challenges and limitations, and also the recommended future research work. So gene editing is a very powerful and advanced technology that enable the scientists to precisely add or remove or alter the DNA sequencing. And this, by the time, also will be reflected on the organism traits and the functions and the different products coming out of it. And we have well-established techniques, several techniques for the process of gene editing. And all the techniques are working about targeting the specific sequence of DNA through specific targeting or guide molecule. And this guide molecule has attached protein which act as a cutter or that will cut the back the two strands of the DNA, giving the chance to insert program the DNA in the target place. And one of the most common and popular technique which work in this is the CRISPR-Cas9, or clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats with CRISPR-associated protein 9. And this was derived from natural defense mechanism in some types of bacteria. Also, there are other similar techniques like transcription activator, like effector nuclease, and this group of proteins that target the DNA and contain a specific domain that act as DNA cutting domain as well, which is the nuclease one. And then we have the zinc finger nucleases, which are artificially designed proteins attached also to certain nucleases that target specific part in the protein and cut the two strands of DNA. Actually, we have many of these methodologies or techniques, but nowadays the most prominent one, due to its high visibility and high simpler application, is the CRISPR-Cas, which has several varieties that enable a wide range of potential applications in new researches. So let us discover some of the real-life potential applications that will lead to clinical advances. Actually, there are many researches done at the last decade focusing on the gene editing in the targeted cancer therapy. And this process of CRISPR used in modification of the genes that stimulate or inhibit the tumor. At the same time, it may also be used for activation or modification of immunotherapy through extracting T cells which from the body of the patient and insert some cancer-associated receptors, and then return it back after making expansion with culture, return it back to the body of the patient, and once it enter, it to start to target and track and kill the tumor cells specifically with minimal side effects that may affect the whole body. Another also important target for gene editing are the blood disorders, especially the genetic blood disorders like sickle cell anemia and beta thalassemia, at which they take the hematopoietic stem cells and make the modification through the modification of the affected mutation in beta globin gene, and so it will produce normal cells. At the same time, there is also modification to increase the fetal hemoglobin, which also can treat the beta thalassemia. Another application is elimination, and this is very recent research for HIV infection, and this could be eliminated from human cell lines. At the same time, it is also successfully eliminated from experimental animals, and this may be a very promising cure for the future cure of the disease. Also, gene editing may help in improving the xenotransplantation and remove all the barriers that lead to rejection of the transplant by modifying the genes in the tissues produced from the pig and make it more accessible to the human tissue. And so it will make more availability of the transplantation organs by the time. Another application is editing for inherited types of blindness through modification of the affected gene and injected in the retina directly, and also in the big target is the highly devastating neurodegenerative diseases that has a challenging effect on the community and also cannot be treated easily. So it is a target of work, and it may show some improvement that may delay or slow down the damaging effect of these diseases. And of course, precision medicine, as the technology help also genetic editing by intermingled with other tools and the new technologies, ensure that the tailored treatment can be given to the person through taking the result of the analysis by the gene editing process, taking the samples and then collecting the multi-omics data coming from the proteins from DNA and RNA together with the clinical data and lifestyle and analysis, of course, by the advanced data system. All this can help finally to introduce personalized medicine that target lead to long-lasting outcome, minimize the side effect if you compare it to the traditional size, one size fits all treatments. And as you see, this may affect the type of treatment and the dose of treatment for each patient according to his condition. Again, gene editing is very significant in advancing the drug discovery procedure, and it can enter in all stages of drug discovery, starting from identifying the drug targets through disabling or knockout of certain specific genes that is claimed to affect the disease. And then identify after identification of these genes, you can start to act by the gene mapping as a potential drug target and guide the development of new therapeutic interventions. After identifying the candidate, validation of the drug target is determined through the phenotype. You are going to check all the protein or the products coming from the genes after its targeting, and ensure this ensure greater accuracy when we choose the potential therapy. Again, dose or response optimization of the drug can be done through gene editing if, according to the gene variant in each patient, that determine is this person or actually most of the people can metabolize this drug in a quick way and they can effectively utilize it. In this case, you are going to give them a normal dose. On the other hand, some people with some genetic variants or more than two genetic variant may have. They have slow or poor metabolism, and this may lead to toxicity and side effect. And of course, all this can be simulated by gene editing and studied to minimize the risk of side reaction and the treatment failure. Also, another step using the gene editing is the screening and the efficacy of the drug screening and efficacy. And this will start by using the gene editing in preparation of specific cell lines. And then these cell lines are going to be subjected to different assays that produce the certain tissues and can be assessed in vitro and then in vivo in the lab before it is given in the clinical trials. So gene editing improved the drug screening in this sequence. At the same time, gene editing could target all the reasons of drug resistance at different levels of the cell by targeting, of course, the genes responsible for these different levels. And of course, this may improve the efficacy, especially nowadays it's applied in treatment of cancer, different chemotherapy. Again, gene editing also can be used in investigating the drug toxicity by creating a certain cell model and with a specific gene modification and check which gene modification can be subjected to more interaction with different drugs and uncover the potential toxic effects and enhancing the drug safety assessment. Of course, all this can lead to general impacts on the healthcare system. And the healthcare system can benefit by identifying the different from the genome or genetic the predisposition. You can check the people having are more liable to disease, and you can improve the patient outcome through early preparation. I can make early intervention, or I can make a modification in the lifestyle and give them advice to avoid further complication. At the same time, similar to other mentioned technologies, gene editing also is important in healthcare cost improvement, and always we can help to avoid trial error in the treatment, reduce the unnecessary medical procedures, ineffective therapies, and of course the associated cost. So the tailored treatment based on genetic information can lead to more efficient resource allocation and cost-effective healthcare delivery. At the same time, as all things related to healthcare, the ethical consideration should be there. And we should, in case of gene editing, a lot of questions market related to the work itself. So if we have a germline editing and inherited changes, the problem of this is that it can be inherited to the coming of future generation. And of course, this may affect the whole population and lead to more genetic diversity and a change in the integrity of the human population. So it should be considered properly. At the same time, this technology can be misused for non-therapeutic purposes, such as creating designer babies, and you enhance special chosen physical or cognitive traits and try to produce it. Another thing, which is mentioned also by my colleagues, is the access and equity. If the gene therapy become available, there may be concern about the affordability and accessibility, and potentially it will lead to disparities in healthcare access between different socioeconomic groups. At the same time, the safety of the patient and the procedure should be guaranteed, because there are some off-target effects. Sometimes if you want to repair the cell, you may damage it, and this may lead to unforeseen health risk and complications for the patient. In the light of this, there are some challenges to apply international consensus between different, the global consensus should be there. To guarantee the ethical, or to keep the ethical boundaries of gene editing in healthcare. And at the same time, the problem is that it should consider all the diverse cultural, religious, and social perspective on genetic modification. Up to my knowledge, that Islamic culture, as long as this procedure is beneficial and away from the interference or misuse, it is allowed for us. The oversight and regulation, we should keep also some regulation that keep the balance between enabling the scientific progress and safeguarding against the misuse or the potential risk. At the same time, there should be also monitoring and continuous editing to avoid the human enhancement, creating designer babies, and there should be robust ethical guidelines and enforcement mechanism to avoid such techniques. In the same time, there should be orientation and public engagement and education for all the stakeholders to ensure transparency, accountability, and broad social input in shaping the policy and regulation related to this work. At the same time, during the research work itself, there should be long-term monitoring and assessment and continuous monitoring of the outcome of the editing treatment and the result of different research work. And there should be to make informed decision how we are going to complete and how we are going to plan the future work. And because of all of this, you'll find, because of all of these ethical warnings, some countries have complete banning. Some countries, if you see here, some the blue colored countries, they have some restrictive rules, and the other, the red colored one, completely make banning of the procedure and legalization, and that's why it needs a better regulation. So while the next point is the challenges, actually the techniques are not so easy, and we have to identify exactly what are the limitations and technical challenges happening in this process. As I told you before, this is the off target, and sometimes you have unintended mutation, which could have adverse consequences on the organism health or introduce new genetic abnormalities. And actually this, nowadays there are toolbox expansion of the CRISPR to try to overcome by making other tools and other targets of the CRISPR. This may reduce the off-target effect. The next point, sorry, is the also, as the techniques are not easy, there should be the precision of the technique, and its efficiency should be guaranteed in the different laboratory. There should be enough equipment, and the laboratory have the most for always endeavors. The foremost priority is to achieve the highest degree of precision in both procedure and outcome, while ensuring optimal utilization of available economic and technical resources. And there is ongoing effort of to critically optimize and enhance these processes under careful consideration through improving the design of the guide RNAs and the novel gene editing enzymes, because if you optimize this, you may guarantee the accuracy in the process of production. One of the new methods for enhancing the accuracy and precision is by new modification in the CRISPR mediated. As I told you before, the CRISPR is worked by binding to the target and then cutting both strands of DNA, and then introduction of the engineered DNA. But a new alternative is just to remove one base. We avoid cutting of the both threads. We keep the thread intact, and just they remove only one base, replace it, or editing one side of the DNA strand and keep the integrity of the strand. Of course, this will be reducing the unwanted off-target effects. The other challenges is the delivery. Actually, we have many delivery tools that help to deliver modified or programmed DNA through viral biological methods, which are through certain viral vectors, or chemical through nanoparticles, or physical through microinjections. And in the way of this vectors, we will find many, many at different cell level, many obstacles. And so the researchers are, or scientists are working on improving, especially the non-viral, which is more safe and efficient to improve the process of delivery. Another last obstacle can be found now is the gene editing is currently efficient, introducing or removing just a point mutation or small stretch of DNA. But it is very difficult or challenging to introduce bigger part or large part of the DNA, and the research work is done nowadays for to improve the large efficient method for large DNA modification. So what are the recommendations for or the ideas for the future use of gene editing in research work? Still, a lot of things can be done, and every day we discover more things that can be done. Extending the treatment for other inherited disorders, we mentioned just the blood abnormalities, but also it can be, and now there are some work directed to the other genetic abnormalities like cystic fibrosis, muscle dystrophy, genetic forms of disease, of diabetes. Also, infectious disease targeting the immune cell and other defense mechanism also can be done to control the infectious disease. Also, we have gene drives for disease control. What is the meaning of this? It means that the desired genetic editing is directed to a huge or through the whole population. And this can be applied efficiently nowadays for to combat the vector-borne diseases like malaria, Zika, and by introducing the gene inside the insect, so it makes it less infectious and ultimately reduce the disease transmission in human and the human suffering, of course. Another target of work is epigenetic changes, and this may be suitable for treating the complex disease with epigenetic components. And also genetic editing is used in aging and longevity research by targeting the genes associated with aging process, and this explore the potential to extend the healthy lifespan and reduce age-related diseases and problems. So
1 minute
to
left,
conclude,
doctor.
Yes, I'm there already.
Thank
I'm
you.
To conclude, the future of gene editing research is incredibly promising with potential applications in disease control, organ transplantation, neurodegenerative diseases, and various other health fields. As technology continues to advance and the ethical considerations are carefully addressed, gene editing is expected to have a profound effect on healthcare, offering innovative solution to complex medical challenges and transforming the way we approach disease prevention and treatment. However, it is crucial to proceed with responsible and the ethical research to ensure the safe and beneficial use of gene editing technologies. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Naglaa.